I'm currently based in Mumbai. I was in Singapore before this. I'm the co-founder of a company called Sellmojo. We enable social commerce. We help brands set up full-fledged e-commerce stores within Facebook.
Just one question. Could you explain why, as a company, I have to sell products on Facebook?
Okay, so the way this started was, in India, a lot of people are already on Facebook. As of now, we have about 82 million people who are on Facebook, who spend upwards of 3 hours every day on Facebook. They are already spending that kind of time talking to people, seeing new posts, interacting with brands. Our idea was, if they were already doing all of that, if they were already speaking to brands, why not also give them the opportunity to buy from the brand?
Okay.
This happens within Facebook, it happens within the infrastructure, and it happens in a way that it's seamless. Which is why the idea of selling on Facebook started off.
Okay, but Facebook was initially a social network dedicated to friends. Why a company have to sell product on Facebook in the middle of the friends relation?
Okay, so the way this works is, what we're trying to do is we're trying to bring social commerce to the fore. Okay, now let's think about it. Let's leave Facebook aside for a moment. Let's say you go out to shop for a t-shirt. Do you ever go alone? You always have somebody with you. So you're going to wear this shirt, you're going to come out, look at yourself, ask the other person, what do you think? Do you think it looks nice? That is what we're bringing on Facebook. So you go to a store, you see a product there, it's there, you take it, you have the option of clicking a button which says ask for an opinion, share it with a friend, ask them, I'm thinking of buying this, what do you think? Okay. They get a link which they can click on, they can buy, you can share it, you can buy it, and you have recommendations coming in from friends, and you can recommend certain products to friends. So very often it happens that you're looking at a certain page, you're looking at products, and you find something that you might not buy, but you know somebody else who will. All you do is you press this button, and we gather all the information, we make it look beautiful, and you straight post it to your friend's timeline. So we're bringing the offline experience of shopping with friends, with people, and it being more social online. That's what we're doing, and we're doing it within Facebook, because Facebook is where everyone is.
Which kind of products are selling more on Facebook through your applications?
Okay, so the demographic on Facebook is still men and women both. Okay. But in terms of products that are really selling, we found that just like Pinterest, it's more of women. So I would say fashion accessories, funky books, notepads, women's clothing, apparels. These are the kind of things that are selling more. These are the kind of things that people want to buy. These are the kind of things that people are sharing, and the more they share, the more the sales are. So it's still a lot oriented towards women.
Okay, and you said gold, coin of gold.
Yes, absolutely. So in India, gold is a big thing.
Okay.
And we've had certain merchants selling gold on their page within Facebook, and we've had transactions to the value of 1 gram, 5 gram, or even a 10 gram gold coin going through. And that's a lot of money.
It's quite expensive.
It is quite expensive, and people are purchasing this within Facebook with that much faith that is going to go through. So it's enabling commerce with products range from as low as 100 rupees to 50,000-60,000 rupees. Absolutely. So in terms of an Indian demographic, we have about 20 to 22 million people on Twitter as of now. These are...
And Twitter, you are not looking for, because it's a social media.
I wouldn't say people who are very evolved in terms of their media, social media taste, but they are people who get Twitter.
Okay.
When it comes to a mass, people are still trying to figure it out. Secondly, what happens with Twitter is that the amount of time that a post stays on Twitter is in minutes.
Okay.
So as soon as somebody, let's say, posts a product, on your timeline, it's gone in about a minute or two.
Okay.
You know, that post is gone. On Facebook, it stays for longer. It's much clearer, and it's the recall is higher. Twitter is much more instantaneous.
Okay.
It happens immediately. We are looking at ways in which we can enable commerce within Twitter. One of the ways is to use product cards, where when anybody shares a tweet, the picture of the product, the price, and the currency is displayed. And if they want to purchase it, all they need to do is click on the button, go to the page, and buy it from
them. That's it.
Yes, it's a little rudimentary, but it works, and that's what we're working with right now. We're hoping to maybe simplify it a little more in the near future.
Okay, very good. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Master.